Exercise 2.2, question number 8. Three consecutive integers are such that when they are taken in increasing order and multiplied by 2, 3 and 4 respectively, they add up to 74. Find these numbers. So we are talking about three consecutive integers here. What are the consecutive integers? The integers which come one after the other. For example, we have 2 and 3. We know that both 2 and 3 are integers. And they are consecutive integers because 3 comes immediately after 2. Is there any integer that comes between 2 and 3? No, there is not. So 3 comes immediately after 2. So we say that 2 and 3 are consecutive integers. Similarly, 8 and 9 are consecutive integers, where 9 comes immediately after 8 and there is no other integer between 8 and 9. What about 12 and 14? 12 and 14 are definitely integers, but they are not consecutive integers because between 12 and 14 there is 13. 14 does not come immediately after 12. So these are not consecutive integers. So here we are talking about three consecutive integers. Right? So let's take these two and add one more integer to it. 4. 4 comes immediately after 3. So 3 comes immediately after 2. 4 comes immediately after 3. So these three are consecutive integers. They come after one another. 2, 3 and 4. Similarly here, if we take 10, 9 comes immediately after 8. 10 comes immediately after 9. So these three are consecutive integers. Now let us see another property of consecutive integers. If we have the first consecutive integer, the first integer given, and we have to find two consecutive integers to it, that is, we need to total of three consecutive integers, and we know the first integer is 2. How do we find the next integer? We will add 1 to it. So if we add 1 to it, we get 3. Which comes immediately after 2. Now to 3, if we add 1, we'll get 4. Right? So this is how we can find the three consecutive integers. Similarly here, if I add 1. Similarly, if we add 1 to 9, we get 10. So this is how you find the consecutive integers. Suppose I consider this one only. Let's ignore this one for now. So we have 2. Add 1 to 2, you get 3. Add 1 to 3, you get 4. So 2, 3 and 4 are 3 consecutive integers. Here I already have the first integer. In the question, I do not know which the first integer is. So, I'll assume it is x. So, I add 1 to x, I get the second consecutive integer. I add 1 to x plus 1 and I get the third consecutive integer. Right? So, my three consecutive integers are x, x plus 1 and x plus 2. Alternatively, here I was talking about 2, 3 and 4. And considering I know the first integer already. Suppose I know the middle integer. Suppose I know 3. So I have 3. How should I get 2? I'll subtract 1 from 3 and I'll get 2. How should I get 4? I add 1 to 3 and I'll get 4. Right? This is how I can find the three consecutive integers as well. But in this case, I already know the middle number is 3. But in the question, the middle number is not given. So I'll assume it is x. So the first number is x, the second number is x minus 1, and the third number would be x plus 1. Clearly, x minus 1 should be placed like this. It should be actually, this is the smallest number, then this is the second number, this is the third number, isn't it? Here this is the first number, second number and third number. Here this is the first number, second number and third number. You can use either of the two. Both are fine. Okay. Let us move on to the question. I'll consider this one for now. So the three integers I have assumed are x, x plus 1 and x plus 2. Next, I've gotten three consecutive integers now, are such that when they're taken in increasing order, these are in increasing order, this is the smallest, then bigger, and multiplied by 2, 3 and 4 respectively. When you talk about the word respectively, it means something like this. A, B and C multiplied by 1, 2 and 3 respectively. So what do you mean by the word respectively? It means the first number given here will be multiplied the first number given here, second number with the second number, third number with the third number. So this is how the relationship would be, the one-to-one relationship it would be. A with 1, B with 2 and C with 3. You know, the first with the first, second with the second, third with the third and so on. Similarly, here we're talking about, we are considering the numbers in increasing order. That is, this is the first number, second number and third number. And they need to be multiplied by 2, 3 and 4 respectively. So first number is 2 here. So 2 will be multiplied by x. Second number is 3. 3 will be multiplied by x plus 1. And the third number is 4. 4 will be multiplied by x plus 2. Okay. So when you do it, they add up to 74. So this plus this plus this will be equal to 74. This will be our equation. Let us see how to write it. Let the three consecutive integers be x, x plus 1, x plus 1 plus 1, right? When the integers are multiplied by 2, 3 and 4 respectively, taking integers in increasing order, they add up to 74. So we have x multiplied by 2 plus x plus 1 multiplied by 3 plus x plus 1 plus 1 multiplied by 4 equal to 74. Now this is our equation. X into 2 will be 2x plus x plus 1 into 3. It will be 3 into x, that is 3x, plus 1 into 3, that is 3 plus, this is x plus 2 into 4 equal to 74. 2x plus 3x is 5x plus 3 plus x plus 2 into 4. 4 into x, 4x plus 4 into 2, 8 equal to 74. 5x plus 4x will be 9x. 3 plus 8 will be 11 equal to 74. Now, x, my variable, is in the left hand side, and the constants 9, 11 and 74 are there. We need to move all the constants to the right hand side. Let's move this 11 first. 11 is getting added here. When it goes to the right hand side, it gets subtracted. So we have 9x equal to 74 minus 11. So 9x equal to 74 minus 11 will be 63. Now 9 is getting multiplied here. When it goes to the right hand side, it gets divided. So 63 upon 9 we get here. Cancellations. 9 ones are 9. 9 sevens are 63. So x is equal to 7 by 1 or 7. Right? So this is our first integer. So we will say first integer is equal to x, which is equal to 7, substituting the value of x. Then second integer equal to x plus 1, substituting the value of x here, 7 plus 1 equal to 8. Then third integer equal to x plus 1 plus 1, substituting the value of x, 7 plus 1 plus 1 will be equal to 9. So the three consecutive integers are 7, 8 and 9. This is our solution. To check if our solution is correct or not, you may consider this statement here. When you multiply the first number by 2, the second by 3 and the third one by 4 and you add them, you will get 74. So do the calculations and figure out if you get 74 or not. That will suggest if the solution is correct or not. Okay.